That isn't the only crime-fighting efforts taking place in St. Louis today. Governor Mike Parson dropped in to see Mayor Lyda Krewson to see if their crime-fighting plans are still on track. This unpublicized meeting was closed to the public, but investigator Elliott Davis got wind of it and had questions for the governor in tonight's You Paid For It.
Governor, I caught up with Governor Mike Parson as he left Mayor Krewson's office through a side door.
Governor, what was the meeting about?
We're just doing a little follow-up work from where we started out on 1st of October, just making sure we're still on the same page and make sure we're moving forward on that.
The governor has agreed to give the mayor about 25 state troopers and other state workers to help and provide some funds for victim services. But Governor Parson also talked about other needs to tamp down crime, jobs.
How do you get those training centers where they need to go on the ground to those people out there instead of expecting them to go somewhere to get it? You know, what I know is they can't go there and get it. So we got to figure out ways to get it to you. And where's a safe area to give it to it at? Where do you get the training at?
Is the state going to give the city millions more resources to do all those things you were just talking about?
You know, we're going to work on it. I don't know what the final result of whether we're going to give millions of dollars.
I talked to Mayor Krewson's chief of staff.
We're doing a number of things, not just the resources from the state of Missouri. But
should you have asked the state for more? Asked the governor for more than you did? Wouldn't that's a pretty small list of things you guys asked for?
Well, to put 24 state employees here, to give me the people on the highway patrol, to actually staff some of the task force that work with the U.S. Attorney's Office and the Alcohol and Tobacco and Firearms Group, those are important asks.
I asked the governor about the city's most expensive new anti-crime initiative that St. Louis imported from out of town that will cost St. Louis taxpayers between $5 and $8 million.
What are your thoughts about the Cure of Violence program that was just approved by the city for $5 million? Your thoughts about that?
Yeah, that's going to be up to the city how they go. We're always trying to search how do we do the best organization we can. Who's really doing good things up here? I think anytime we're investing in these programs, you just got to make sure they're out there getting an end result with good results out of that to make sure we're making a dent.
I asked Mayor Lyda Krewson about the city's big bet on Cure of Violence. She voted for it.
Do you expect it to dramatically bring down homicides in this city, Cure of Violence?
Everyone's hopeful of that, and I think what we have to do is get started and begin working it.
It's a big challenge to do the violent crime situation because it's been over a decade of this stuff forming up here. And to realize, to even think you're going to get this fixed in a week or a month or even maybe a year.
As for the resources the governor promised from the state, all the highway patrol troopers not here yet, and the city has yet to receive the funds for victim services. As for Cure of Violence, the main backer, Board of Aldermen President Lewis Reed, says we probably won't see a dramatic drop in murders to next summer. Of course, I'll keep you posted. After all, you paid for it.